So now that you know the full range of his talents, I am proud to introduce a true champion in the fight against tobacco and the recipient of our 2012 Champion Award, Dr. Howard Koh.
Thank you so much, Susan, for that wonderful introduction. And I am so privileged to receive this award. And I want to thank you and the Campaign for Tobacco-Free Kids for this great, great honor. In particular, I want to thank the leaders of this organization, the board, Bill Novelli, and my very, very good friend, Matt Myers, who has saved so many lives and inspired so many more. Matt has taught me, humbled me, and every day leaves me in awe. So I am delighted to be here to work so closely with all of you, with Susan and Matt, and they deserve a great round of applause. On a night like this, two wonderful sayings come to mind. First, Kierkegaard once said, "You can only understand your life backwards, but you have to live it forwards." And second, is this wonderful saying, "The two most important days of your life are the day you were born and the day you understand why you were born." So both of those pieces of wisdom resonate deeply with me tonight. As you know, I serve as a U.S. Assistant Secretary for Health, and at the department, everything has an acronym, so I am known there as the ASH. Given my history in tobacco, to be known as the ASH is just a bit ironic, but also perhaps destiny, too. And it is a joy to receive this award before so many true friends gathered here, because after all, the definition of a true friend is someone who knows everything about you, but loves you anyway. So I want to begin by dedicating this incredible night to the many patients who motivated me to start this journey decades ago. I never began my medical career intending to work on tobacco. I just wanted to cure my patients and help them enjoy the fragile gift of health. But in my more than 30 years as a physician and clinician, I came to witness too many of my patients crushed by the avalanche of addiction caused by tobacco. When your patient suffers and dies, that is a source of great personal and professional anguish. But when your patient suffers and dies a preventable death, that anguish haunts you forever. And as I saw patient after patient leaving this earth far too soon, despite all the best treatments of modern medicine, I found myself saying, there's got to be a better way. I have since discovered that when you say, there's got to be a better way, that's the beginning of a journey that can help you turn anguish into action, and that great journey is called public health. As a young medical trainee, I remember being first introduced to that time-honored hospital teaching ritual called attending rounds. In this regular exercise, students and interns present an interesting case to the attending faculty member who in turn leads an hour-long discussion about care and treatment options. I remember so clearly being that young intern who was presenting the case of a new patient with lung cancer. The attending physician carefully asked about the history and the physical exam, the biopsy results and the staging, the treatment options, and the prognosis, which was very grim. Then in the very last minute of the session, as the discussion was ending, the attending physician concluded, "You know, this is all caused by tobacco. Someone should do something about this." Years later, my friends, I can say that someone is you. And that someone is me. And that someone is all of us who step forward and say, we will no longer tolerate the intolerable or accept the unacceptable. We owe it to the patients we will see, we owe it to the patients we will never see, and we owe it to future generations so people don't become patients in the first place. Thank you. Thank you. Almost 3 years ago, on Friday, June 19, 2009, I had the privilege of being confirmed by the U.S. Senate after first being nominated by President Obama. On the following Monday, June 22, 2009, I reported to duty for my first day at work at HHS headquarters, mere blocks from our nation's capital. And to my amazement, I was told that my very first responsibility as the ASH was to travel to the White House, to the Rose Garden, and support the President as he signed into law the historic Family Smoking Prevention and Tobacco Control Act, which gave the FDA unprecedented authority to regulate tobacco. Who could possibly plan something like that? And as I joined that gathering in the Rose Garden and savored the history of that moment, I reflected again on the notion that this public health journey is not an accident. It is, for those of us in this room, our duty and indeed our destiny. The most important person who has accompanied me on this journey is my wife, Dr. Claudia Arig. Claudia has loved and supported me every step of the way. And next week, we are celebrating our 31st wedding anniversary. And by the way, as you heard, Claudia is a world-class physician and ophthalmologist in her own right. And at functions like this, she's always a hit because everyone wants free advice on their vision and eyesight. So if you have a question for Dr. Claudia, the line starts right here, right after the program ends. And I also want to pay respects to my tremendous colleagues at the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services who are so dedicated to tobacco control, including Secretary Sebelius, Deputy Secretary Bill Corr, and HHS General Counsel Bill Schultz, who is here tonight. Working together, we are implementing the first ever HHS strategic plan for tobacco control, and we are very proud to work with you every step of the way. And very importantly, I want to also acknowledge some incredible colleagues at HHS, my wonderful tobacco control team who are in attendance tonight, Rosie Henson, Simon McNabb, Katie McMahon and Cliff Douglas. And in fact, I want all my HHS colleagues to stand up and get a round of applause from all of you, please. Thank you. So as I close, I share one final saying. Everyone journeys toward an end, but in the end, what matters is the journey. It is a privilege to travel with you on this journey as we revitalize and reinvigorate our nation's commitment to tobacco control. We have just begun a new chapter, and we have miles to go before we sleep. But I know with the passion, dedication, and commitment of everyone in this room, we can end the tobacco epidemic once and for all. Thank you, and God bless you all. Thank you.